Let's see how far we can get with this. So I'll load this into a new tab. This requires CMake. This requires Libuv. I'm not sure if I've got Libuv or not. Lib. No, it's not there, so we need that one. That hasn't got any dependencies, so curl we haven't got. We need to install that. We've got make CA, Libarchive we haven't got. Yeah, once again we're getting into a big I can actually reinstall this at a later point, actually, this one. Optional, let's see what these two have got. LZO and Nettle. That's okay. Nettle's okay, actually, so we'll keep with that one. Nghttp. That's got some options as well. So there's going to be a few more packages here to rebuild. For the recommended packages and optional ones there. So, right, there's a fair bit of work to do here still. So I'll start with this libuv, and that's in chapter 9. Yep. Okay. So I'm going to tidy this up. I'm going to unset those two, what they're called, GetMDRV and DRI drivers. Can't do that one. Gnome DRV. So unset these two, just in case they're used by anything else. Unlikely, but never know. And I'm going to switch back to the browser, go back to the menu, and look for this libuv. It is download, save. Caution, the sh autogen command below fails if the AC local environment variable is set as specified in Xorg 7. If it is used, AC local needs to be unset for this package and then reset for other packages. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to another login where I can unset this and then just log out, so I don't have to worry about setting it or unsetting it. So if I echo it, you can see it's set there. So unset AC local, echo it again, it's gone, and I should be able to now build this in this terminal here. Libuv. Paste these commands, wait for it to build. Okay, that's done. So I run the tests now, make check. But to go back to the correct virtual terminal. Well, it says one test pass, but it looks like there was 397 to me, judging by how that was counting up. But anyway, that looks successful. Let's install the package. Oh, again, on the correct terminal. Okay, and that's done. So I can now clear that up and quit this terminal because it hasn't got the correct AC local setting in case that's needed for anything else we're doing. And I'll go back to my graphical browser, Libuv. You can see there's no more dependencies, so I'm going to sign this one off, chapter 9. Cross that out. And move on to curl. So that libuv, which one was it? Oh, it was for CMake, was it? Oh, yes, it is. Yeah, it's a requirement. That's right. So, yeah, curl, we've already got make CA. That's a recommended. The rest are optional. There is one or two of these I might install, so I'm going to mark this one down as a rebuild again. It's a bit unfortunate, it's just a load more work, but these dependencies, and if you really want the extra functionality that some of the optional packages can give, then it's a necessary evil. So let's push that out of the way, go back to the contents, look for curl. There it is. Download. So optional if running a test suite. Okay, so they look like they're extra tests. I don't really want to install Valgrind. On this build, it pulls in a lot more dependencies and the tests take a lot longer. They are more thorough, but I don't think it's necessary in this build. Right, so let's extract curl. This grep command to make the build use Python 3. Let's see if there's any other options here. Resolver. SSH2, that's one of the options, I think. Yes, it is. So yeah, the other commands that are, or options that are specified, are for if the optional packages are installed, but they're not. So I'll just take the default, paste that in, and next time I install this package, I'll ensure the options are installed and rebuild it then. Right, it's built. Let's run the tests, see what happens. Well, that finished and got 100% passed on the tests. So I think we can install that. It's all done. And some simple tests, it says here. So let's run these as the unprivileged user. And it says to inspect the locally created trace files. Alright, we can run both of these. Okay, that didn't work on one line, unfortunately. So I'll just type this in manually. So the two files are called debug dump.txt. It looks like that's worked. And the other one was just simply d.txt. Yep, that looks good as well. So that appears to be working. So as I said, that's going to be reinstalled. Networking libraries after the options. And I'll get rid of that for now. The next one I'm going to go to is Nettle. So let's tidy up curl. RM1.f and extract Nettle. So configure and make. No extra options for the configure command. Okay, that's done. So let's run the tests. that's all passed. So we can install the package. And that's done. Right, so that hasn't got any dependencies that I'm interested in. This is just for the tests. So I'll get rid of Nettle. Nettle is one of the security packages. So you can see, as I mentioned, time we're doing the security packages, how some of these get knocked off as being completed. So the next package we've got is LZO. LZO. Here it is. So extract it. And there's no extra configuration options, so I'll just go straight in and build it. All done. Let's run, make a check. And it says make test for exhaustive testing, as it says here. So it looks like the first make check's just initial sanity check. All tests passed, so that's good. Let's install with a simple make install. All done. So that's LZO complete. That's in general libraries. So mark that off as completed. LZO, and now I've got Libarchive. So we've got all the optional dependencies installed. That's good. Libarchive. So that should be in the same chapter here. There it is. Okay, so we've got so two extra switches without XML2 and without Nettle. So we've got both of these, so we don't need to add them. We can just configure and make. All complete. Let's run some tests. Okay, so those four tests have all passed. Let's go to install, and it's a simple make install. And that's complete. That's going to get crossed off as it's all complete. And I'll go back to my browser, check the next package, which is Nghttp. So this is going to have to be a rebuild because there's some options there I'll have to look into. I decided I don't want to install them, but chances are they will be useful. So okay, Nghttp. Nghttp. So let's have a look at the commands. Enable lib only. Make the switch if you'd like to build the example. Okay, so we don't want the examples, so we'll keep the options that are there and build it. Right, that's compiled. There's no usable test suite, so we just install this. And that's done. Get the browser back. So Nghttp, I'm going to put a R next to that for the options to rebuild that.